Good evening, Andreas. We are with Andreas, a young German podcast scientist, podcast scientist in training. You are doing your PhD research. You are working on Ghana, and you've been in Accra for about 3 months.
Right.
But also, I think this is a very interesting time to be in Ghana for PhD research in political science. What has been your impression of Ghanaian politics so far?
That it is very vivid, above all. That's the most important thing that I realized, that people are actually talking about politics, whether it's in the trottoir or whether it's on parties on the street when I'm shopping. So there's actually like political life in the streets and going on. And for me, the most important thing in a democracy, in an evolving democracy, is always that there's like a kind of culture developing, that people understand that they actually participate and that they are actually in charge of putting the people up there, and that they can also say, all right, we are not satisfied with you anymore, we can withdraw you from your post. And I think that's something that people do understand and do get into by talking and discussing all these things. So I think it's very important.
How would these aspects that you describe compare with Germany, where you come from?
I think in Germany it takes much longer that people get emotional about politics. I think in Ghana people are much more emotional about it, that they kind of are much more related to it in that sense. In Germany it's more, at least in the circles that I'm like living in, it's more that people are talking calm on certain topics, and it's much more seldom that they're actually really like becoming
so
emotional.
So you think Ghanaians talk more about politics?
And above all, more emotional.
That's more emotional.
That's the
but
the
being thing emotional about politics can be bad.
It can be bad.
So
yeah.
Are you saying Ghanaians are worse off politically than Germans?
No, that I wouldn't say. It's just a different quality. It's you need passion for politics. That's very important. You need that people are interested. We will see it in the elections, what the voter turnout is. If that passion and that emotion is actually turning out to be a high voter participation, then it's just the best thing that could happen.
So would you say this is good? What is happening in Ghana is, in a sense, better than what you have in Germany?
In Germany, we would need some more passion about politics.
You can learn something from Ghana.
Yeah, I think so, because there are many people who are kind of like fed up with politics, that say we're having a democracy now since the Second World War, since how many years? 40, 50, 60 about, since 45, and still things are not going better for a certain part of the population. So there are people that are saying, all right, it doesn't matter whether I'm interfering or whether I'm not interfering, and I have the feeling that this...
We don't want to involve themselves politically.
Yeah, and I have the feeling that people in Ghana are much more like participating with their heart, with their emotion, and that this commits them more to politics. Of course, the other thing is talking about topics and talking about things like how do things change, what should we do to change things. Maybe that's something that in Ghana should be discussed more seriously, like really going into political topics. I think that's maybe more in Germany, that people like talk about the actual healthcare system, how it works and what should be improved.
So you say the political discussion in Ghana is not sufficiently about issues. Would you agree to that?
It's always like if I would talk about tendencies, then yes. In Ghana, I have the feeling the tendency is rather on emotions, on do I like the guy that is going for elections, or do I like the party? And in Germany, it's I think it's more on topics, but at the same time less emotional. So I think it's a combination of both that is needed. And
you know, there's a lot of concern that there might be some problems with security or peace around the election. What's your own impression? You feel safe enough being in Ghana around the election?
Definitely. I've seen lots of rallies, of NDC rallies, MPP rallies, and even me being a foreigner and being obviously a foreigner, being white, I never felt threatened at all. I will see if my judgment is right on the 7th of December then. I can't say it now.
Are your family and friends not worried? You are in Ghana around election time?
It depends. When there's a kind of like group of people that is not really, that doesn't really know much about Africa, and they have like the imagination, Africa, it's dangerous. So that's one group of people, and Africa and election combination is much more dangerous. But of course there are also people that are going more in details and that see that Ghana is a country where it's fine to be at elections.
Andreas, thank you very much.